And then after, when we have the carcasses, we need to do chewing of the carcasses. If we do that as soon as possible, then we reduce or increase the growth of microorganism, reduce the microbial growth. But should we do it as fast as possible, like within 1 hour? No. There are some recommendations, and this you need to learn. For beef, we lower the temperature to 6 to 7 within 28 to 36 hours. We should not do very fast. Why? Then we would explain in the next chapter. Okay. And for pigs, we need shorter time, 12 to 16, 24 to 30 hours for sheep, carcasses. For chicken, can be like 1 or 2 hours, very fast. Okay, and in the chilling room, high air speeds are needed for rapid cooling, but this will lead to increased weight losses due to evaporation unless relative humidity of the air in the room is also high. Do you understand this sentence? Okay. In order to do faster chilling, the air in the room must ventilate, must move. When it's moved, it takes the heat from the carcass out, so it lowers the temperature of the carcass. If the air is static, static means stand still. Okay. If the air is static, then the chilling rate, the chilling speed is not fast enough. When the chilling is too slow, what would happen? What would be the risk? When the dropping down of temperature is too slow, then there would be a chance for microorganisms to grow and spoil the meat, but also will cause food poisoning if they are pathogens. Okay, so in order to do fast enough chilling, we need the air to move. When the air ventilated or moved fast, then we have rapid cooling, but this will lead to weight loss because of the evaporation, unless the relative humidity of the air should be high. Do you get the sentence? I will just explain further here. Okay. Just give an example so you would understand that sentence. Now, on the table, I put like, or maybe just a piece of fresh meat, beef, for example, and then also a piece of dry beef, very dry beef. After 1 night, what would happen with the weight of this piece of meat? Is this reduced or increased? Reduce the weight of this one after 1 night. What happened with the weight of this dry, very dry beef? Increase. Why? Why? This, the weight increased because of what? Because it absorbed the water vapor from the air. And why the weight here is reduced? Because the water in the fresh meat, what happened? Evaporate. Evaporate means occur. The water evaporates to the air and then you lose weight. So I have a question. Why in this case it evaporates? Why in this case it absorbs? Why? Based on the difference between water activity of food and relative humidity of surrounding air. The fresh meat has a lot of water, especially free water, and then it has high water activity. What is the maximum value of water activity? 1. So the water activity of fresh meat is almost 1. Here, the water activity of dry beef, because it's dry, the remaining water is strongly bound inside the meat. So the water activity here is small, maybe like 0.35 or 0.4, for example. Okay, And then relative humidity outside in Vietnam, relative humidity of the air is quite high. For example, here in the fridge, relative humidity in the surrounding air it may be like 75%, mean 0.75 or 75%. Okay. So if you see this water activity is higher than the relative humidity of the surrounding air, so the evaporation, you see, is moved from the higher water activity to smaller. You can call this water activity. So the evaporation is higher than the absorption. Actually, there is also absorption, but it's much smaller than the evaporation. In this case, it's different. The absorption is much higher than the evaporation. Because now, outside more moisture, inside less moisture. And at the result, this one gain weight, this one loses weight. Okay, what is relative humidity? Độ ẩm tương đối. What is that? Did you study food engineering? Okay, right. When you watch TV, like a weather forecast with your parents, and then the MC in the TV will say, wow, the air in Đà Lạt is very humid these days. Early in the morning, the relative humidity can reach up to 99, 95, or 100%. Relative humidity of the air can be up to 100%. Nghĩa là ẩm tương đối rất cao, có thể 100% trong không khí. Bố mẹ mình mới hoảng lên. Ok vậy con? Vậy con đâu oxy thở? Không khí nước không à? And how do you answer? And then your parents listen to like television weather forecast and they will say the relative humidity is so high. The air is very humid. It can reach up to 100% of relative humidity. And your parents are panicked because they would think, wow, there's no oxygen to breathe because 100% of water in the air. What does that mean? Is that true that there would be no oxygen to breathe? But what does that mean? When relative humidity is 100%, what does that mean? Okay. When the relative humidity is 100%, mean it already hold maximum amount of vapor it can hold. Okay? It doesn't mean that it's only vapor in the air. Air always has almost 80% of nitrogen and almost 20% of oxygen. And the rest, vapor, CO2, CO, and whatever, many other components, less than 1%. Okay? So the vapor in the air will never go beyond, or rarely go beyond 1%. Phải giải thích lại chỗ này nha, tiếng Việt. Ẩm tương đối 75% không có nghĩa là không khí có 75% là hơi nước, mà có nghĩa là nó đã chứa 75% hơi nước, lượng nó có khả năng chứa. Ví dụ trong 1 kg không khí nó có thể chứa là 25 g nước. Không khí ở một cái điều kiện 25 g nước, thì khi mà cái không khí đó có đủ 25 g nước rồi trong 1 kg luôn nha, thì có nghĩa là không 25 là hơi cao. Ví dụ thôi nha. Khi mà nó chứa 25 g thì là chứa 100%. Okay, right. So we go back. So now, if the air speeds are high, then the evaporation would be high if the relative humidity is low. So normally in chilling room, they increase the relative humidity to have less evaporation, to have less weight losses of the carcasses. Okay? When you increase the relative humidity near to the water activity of meat, then there would not be a lot of evaporation. But then the question, why they don't increase to 100% relative humidity? If you increase to 100% relative humidity, you will not lose weight. Because, how do you call that? Because the evaporation would be the same to absorption. Then why? Why we don't make the air so humid? If the air is so humid, if the relative humidity is too high, what would happen? Then the surface of the carcass should be will be wet, right? And then this is favorable condition for mold and bacteria to grow. So you need also dry surface of carcasses, relative humidity at about 90% with the air speed about 0.5 meter per second. These are optimum conditions. Okay, so in some chapter, we will discuss about drying. We use the air to dry, right? We heat up the air to 60 degrees C, for example, in 1 meter, and then to dry the food, to make food dry. But if you go on streets and you see that people keep the momo warm, you know momo? Bánh bao. When they keep it warm in a chamber like this, the temperature is also like 55 degrees C, for example, to keep the cake warm all whole day. The temperature is also high, but why the cake do not get dry?
Why?
Là em đi dọc đường thấy người ta làm ẩm bánh bao không? Để trong cái tủ nó ấm hoài, nhiệt độ 55-60 rồi cả ngày, nhưng cái bánh bao nó có khô không? Không. Why? Why they do not get dry? Because the air inside is saturated. With what? Water vapor. They use water here to heat. They heat the water actually, so the water evaporates. A lot of vapor inside the chamber. The air is very humid. It cannot take vapor anymore. So when water evaporates from the cake, it's also absorbed from the environment. Then it will not get dry. Okay. Trường hợp này không gọi là sấy mà gọi là hấp rồi nha. Steam. And this one, if you can explain this sentence and you would understand everything that I have been just talking. Condensation will occur if warm carcasses are put in a cooler partially filled with cold carcasses. Do you understand that sentence? Okay, I will draw again here. Example. Now, you have chilling chamber in the morning or today, you already have several carcass and the temperature is already like 7 degrees C, for example. And now today you put new carcass, the temperature may be like still 30 degrees C, for example. And the sentence says that the water will evaporate from here and will condensate into the cold carcasses. Here you call it evaporation. And here what do you call? Condensation. Là ngưng tụ. Còn bên này là bốc hơi. Okay, why this happen? So why when it's cooler then it will condense? Why the vapor condense when it's neat and when it reach the cooler surface or cooler temperatures? Okay, you can explain that by looking this one. You can go to my YouTube channel and you watch Food Engineering Study Chapter 6, Psychromatics, chương về không khí ẩm. Okay, right. To understand that, you try to remember what you study in food engineering. Does the relative humidity of the air is actually dependent on the temperature of the air? It will change according to the temperature. But the absolute humidity, it will not depend on the temperature, okay? As long as there is no phase conversion. All right, yes? And you try to look at that chapter and you will know that, for example, this is a psychrometric chart. This is temperature of the air, okay? And so you have, this is relative humidity. And this side is absolute humidity. This is relative humidity, 100%, 90%, 80%, 70%. So one absolute humidity, you see, one value, can have different, what? Relative humidity. If the temperature of the air is different, okay? So when you lower the temperature of the air, you actually increase the what? Relative humidity. What is absolute? Absolute means is gram of water per kilogram of dry air. Bao nhiêu gam nước trên kilogram không khí là ẩm tuyệt đối. Còn ẩm tương đối là gì? Bao nhiêu mol của hơi nước trên số mol của nước ở trạng thái bão hòa là số mol tối đa không khí có thể chứa, là ẩm tương đối. Còn ẩm tuyệt đối thì như thế này. Ok. Means that if you lower the temperature, the air would reduce its capacity to hold moisture. Because it becomes more saturated, it can uptake less and less. Right. So now, you go and drink coffee with your friend, and within the coffee, we normally put ice, and the temperature here is cold, maybe a 0 degree C, 4 degree C, for example. And after a while, you would observe that you see drop of water on the surface of the cup. Why this happened? Why did this happen? And your girlfriend would ask you, you study food technology, engineering. Can you explain? Okay, you are a real engineer. Okay. Còn bạn khác thì trả lời chắc cái ly này, ly Trung Quốc đó em, nó thấm nước ra. Okay. Xong rồi bạn gái nhìn qua, ủa vậy cái anh bên kia anh uống bằng cái ly inox mà sao nó còn dữ nhiều hơn nữa. Inox nó cũng thấm luôn hả? Trả lời sao? Để anh chị em xem lại. Okay. So what's the reason you look at this cyclometric chart? Okay, you see the temperature outside maybe here. Temperature maybe like 30 degrees C for example. Okay, and here for example the temperature like 20 and 10, and then here maybe like 4 whatever. For example, okay, no, not 4. It's actually here maybe like 5, and then another temperature here maybe 0. Just make an example. Okay, so the air here, exactly, what is relative humidity in Vietnam? Maybe 85%. Okay, when the air move nearer and nearer to the cup, the temperature, what happened with the temperature? Going down. So the relative humidity, what? Go up. Okay, so when the air reach here, the relative humidity become 100%. This means that the air is already saturated. What does that mean? Which means that it already has maximum amount of vapor it could have. And then what happened? What happened if you reduce the temperature further? Yeah. So you look at here, at this stage, the air is already saturated, means 100% of relative humidity. But if you lower the temperature further, so this curve will go like this, from here to go down here, to reach the temperature 0 degrees C, 2 degrees, okay? Because the relative humidity cannot go beyond 100%. And then what do you see now? The temperature at the surface of the cup is too low, it's like at 0 degrees C. And then you see that this will go like that. The air there is actually saturated, still 100%. But however, what happened with the absolute humidity? What happened? Reduced. The absolute humidity reduced. What does that mean? Means that vapor in the air now become condensate. Là nước lỏng ngưng tụ ra. The vapor condenses into liquid. So there would be less vapor in the air, okay? So the condensation occur because the relative humidity reach 100%. Right, here, why the condensation occur here? Because the temperature here is low enough that the air becomes saturated, condensate. Now, you explain in Dalat, or even in the center of Vietnam, in the morning, there is very often the fox in the morning. Can you explain? You don't see the fox at noon time, but you see in the morning.
Why?
Normally, for example, at noon time, the temperature is high, 30 degrees C, for example. The relative humidity is somehow 0.85 or 0.9. But in the morning, the temperature is going down, 15 degrees C, for example. And the same amount of water in the air, the same amount of absolute humidity, but in the morning, what increase? Relative humidity increase. When it reached 100%, what happened? Condensation. Condensation means the vapor become liquid and it becomes small droplets of liquid. Very small droplets of liquid, of water. Những cái hạt nước nhỏ li ti trong không khí ấy, nó ngưng tụ lại, nước lỏng. Trời mưa ở trên đó cũng vậy. Mưa biết mây không? Mây nhiều, mây là cái gì? Là hơi nước. Khi nào nó mưa, có một làn gió lạnh thổi đến làm nhiệt độ của nó làm sao? Hạ xuống, làm cho không khí ở chỗ đó trở nên bão hòa, ngưng tụ, nước lỏng rớt xuống. Hạt nó to nó rớt thôi. Còn the fog particles are small, which will not drop down. Fly in the air. And when the sun rises, the temperature increases, what happens with the droplets of water? Evaporate into vapor and you don't see anymore. Okay, now we go back here. Now the chilling room already has chilled carcasses, the temperature which is already low. Now you put the warm carcasses in the chilling room, the relativity is less than 100%. Water activity of these carcasses are almost 1, means 1%, 100%. And then water will evaporate. But then when it's moved to here, the temperature lower. And here is very low, it's rich saturation and the condensation occur here. That's what happened. I have another example, if you could explain and then understand. In the fridge at home, you have a freezing chamber here. This part you have chilling chamber. Chilling, the temperature is less than 7, okay? Somehow from 1 to 7 degrees C. Here maybe minus 18 degrees C if you have a good fridge. And here there is a small boxes where you put vegetable, veggies. Now, if you put a fresh leaf, if you put a fresh leaf outside on the table, and if you put a fresh leaf here inside in this large part of the chamber, overnight, which leaf will get weaker faster, do you think? The leaf outside or inside will get weaker faster. Weaker có nghĩa là nó bị héo, cái nào nó bị héo nhanh hơn, dry. Which one get dry faster? Inside or outside? Outside. Who do you think inside? Which who you think inside get weaker faster? Actually, the one inside get dry faster. Nó bị héo nhanh hơn. Why? Because the relative humidity in your chilling chamber is smaller than the relative humidity outside the air. Means that the evaporation here is faster than the evaporation here. But the question is why? The question is why the relative humidity here is lower? I will just give an example. Now you are sitting in an air-con room, right? This room has an air-con. And outside there, the air, relative humidity outside the air and relative humidity in the room. Which one is higher, do you think? Outside there and inside here, which one is higher? Outside. What inside here is lower? Huh? It's the same with a fridge. Eh? The relative humidity inside is lower, means that the difference between water activity and relative humidity of the air is higher and the evaporation is faster. Okay. You stay at home, you sleep in an aircon room, for example, your room at home, so the aircon has two parts. One is you call that the warmer part, right? And then the other one is the cooler part, right? That's the at home. And then what happened? This is what happened with the air in your room. The air is out, in, and move inside, and then out, circulate like that. And then you will see that there is a pipe. They connect a pipe here. They connect outside. And if you look and you see water dripping down, okay? Where does that water come from? Ủa em có thấy cái máy điều hòa nó có cái ống nước cái sao nó nhỏ 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 ra bên nhà thiên hạ không? Where does this come from? Hả? We will study this more in the chapter of chilling and freezing. But here you already understand based on the psychrometric chart. Exactly, these two parts of the atom are connected by two pipes. Có hai cái ống đó. Nó gói với nhau, nó có hai cái ống nó chạy vòng 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 trong đó. Ngôi chất lạnh nó chạy ở trong đó. And here có một cái dàn là dàn evaporator, là cái bộ bốc hơi ở trong cái chỗ này này. So your air is moving to exchange the heat with the evaporator here. And the air will lose the heat. We lose the heat, so the temperature of the air is going down. Okay? The temperature here is T1 is higher than the temperature at the evaporator T2. The air will move, the air, when the air move like this, it go and reach the lower temperature, right? When it reach lower temperature, what happened with relative humidity? Increases. And what happened when it reach 100%? Condensation. And the vapor in your room become condensate, become liquid water. That's why they have to connect with a pipe to take the liquid out. So this water actually is a condensate, which is formed from the vapor of the air in your room. And then the air in your room become drier and drier, time to time. Không khí ấy, nó trở nên khô 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 hơn. Em ngồi máy điều hòa và em đã thấy cái môi em nó khô dần nó nứt nẻ. Ok? Tại vì nước từ cái môi em nó bốc hơi ra ngoài mà. The air become drier inside because the condensation occur here. In the fridge, there's a heat exchange here, the evaporator is here. Cái phần cái bộ bốc hơi của thiết bị ấy, là nó nằm như sau này, cái chỗ này nó lạnh hơn. The temperature here may be 0 degree C. And the temperature in the room may be 7 degree C. The air from here, when the air move to this, it will reach lower temperature, it will reach saturation, and then condensation occur here. And this air move out, become drier, and the relative humidity lower, okay? It's like that. So when you open your fridge, you see at the back, you see actually condensate of water at the back. Mở tủ lạnh anh thấy nhìn cái lưng phía sau nó sẽ thấy những giọt nước ở trên đó. Mà nước này từ đâu ra là do hơi nước trong không khí nó gặp cái bề mặt lạnh nó ngưng tụ nè. Làm cho không khí bên trong ở này càng ngày càng khô. Ẩm tương đối sẽ thấp hơn cho nên em nếu anh để cái lá rau vô đây nó sẽ héo rất nhanh. Anh thử đi em làm anh thử. Nên người ta thiết kế một cái hộp làm rau ở dưới này nè. Để cho cái không khí nó không có vòng xuống, nó không có đối lưu được nhiều ở đây. Vừa phải thôi. Nhưng nó mất ít khô chứ không để trên nó khô nha. Ok. If you go to European country, especially during the winter, you will see that all people use lipstick. You know lipstick? Đàn ông, đàn bà gì cũng dùng gọi là gel thoa môi chứ không phải là son môi. Lần đầu tiên em đi qua ví dụ ngồi châu Âu thấy tự nhiên mấy người ngồi ông bà gì đang ngồi chờ xe buýt bắt đầu cầm cái thỏi ra bôi 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 lên cái môi nè. Tại sao họ bôi? Em mà không bôi á, năm đầu tiên em qua là nhiều khi nó khô và nó nứt nẻ, nó chảy máu luôn cái môi em luôn. Tại vì ở bên châu Âu đến cái mùa đông khí hậu có thể âm, khí hậu thấp lắm, mà cái gì nó thấp nữa là cái này nó rất thấp, ẩm tương đối trong không khí nó rất thấp cho nên nước từ cái môi qua nó bốc hơi nhanh lắm, nó khô nó nứt nẻ luôn. Người ta phải bôi lên một cái lớp gel để chống mất ẩm. Ở Hà Nội nếu mà nhiệt độ xuống 15 độ C là em thấy nó lạnh như ở châu Âu nhiệt độ xuống 0 độ C vậy. Châu Âu nhiệt độ xuống thấp hơn mà mình cũng không thấy rất lạnh vì không khí nó khô lắm. Ok, right. So now we go back. Condensation will also occur if warm carcasses are put in a cooler partially already filled with cold carcasses. In which carcasses the evaporation occur, in which carcasses the condensation occur, you have to know because you will see in the exam. Now, the cooler should not be overloaded. Overload means you stack so many carcasses like this, the air cannot ventilate inside, and then the chilling, the cooling rate is not fast enough. When the carcasses are actually lodged, especially the temperature in the middle will go down, will drop down slowly. If it takes too long time to drop down, then this is a chance for microorganism to grow in the middle, especially the anaerobic one. Arabic bacteria can grow in the middle of the carcasses. Okay, when once filled, the cooler should be closed and the door should not be opened so often. If you open the door so often, the temperature can move up and down. When it moves up, the temperature of the carcasses will go up. This is also the chance for microorganisms to grow. Okay, and of course the cooling drum should be washed and cleaned carefully when you empty